Before you see a cool visual way to understand compression, I want to start with why we want to compress to begin with. Let's think about the idea of ebb and flow. That is, that any sound coming out of your speakers moves back and forth. There are quiet parts and louder parts. I could even demonstrate that with my voice right now. The closer I am to the microphone, the louder my voice is. The further I am away, the quieter my voice is. You can think of these volume differences as the dynamic range of audio. And the reason we compress is that we want this ebb and flow, this back and forth, to be more manageable and more controlled. If a sound has less dynamic range, it's easier to focus on and pay attention to because it feels tighter, more consistent, and, well, more even. Just look and listen to this take before compression. And then look and listen at this take after compression. The compressed take with less dynamic range should feel more consistent and more under control. But just because you understand what it means to compress, that doesn't mean you understand how to use a compressor. So let's do a visual example. Here's a waveform representing any audio. And here's a compressor. The threshold of a compressor is the level at which the effect of compression is engaged, or put more simply, only signals that cross this threshold get compressed. Attack is the time it takes for the signal to become fully compressed. And release is actually the opposite. It's the time it takes for the compressed signal to return back to its uncompressed original state. Ratio specifies the amount of reduction applied to the signal above the threshold. And these ratios are expressed in decibels. So a 2-to-1 ratio indicates that a signal exceeding the threshold by 2 dBs gets attenuated down to 1 dB. Or an 8-to-1 ratio would mean a signal exceeding the threshold by 8 dBs gets attenuated down to 1 dB. Now, let's not get too excited by compression. Many digital sounds don't need compression to sound consistent because they have little to no dynamic range to begin with. But at the very least, when it comes to organic sounds performed imperfectly by humans, you'll almost always want to reach for a compressor. And once you do, the different types of compressors, ratios, and attack and release settings you settle on will drastically affect the vibe and feel of your music. Make sure to check out all our free workshops, resources, learning guides, and sample packs. And of course, scope out all our free videos as well.